First, welcome to Tennessee. We are thrilled that you're here. This is an exciting place to be, to have a conversation about driving student learning and to have some of the greatest minds across the country who are covering this increasingly interesting debate. We are thrilled that you're here and taking such a deliberative approach on learning about important issues that are driving conversations within the 50 states. So today's conversation is going to be the Tennessee story from F to fastest, and talk a little bit about what it's looked like to preserve the implementation process for Tennessee's Common Core State Standards here at home. So first, before we talk about where we're going and where we are in Tennessee, it's important for us to reflect on where we've been. In Tennessee in 2007, we were not telling the truth. We were saying that 9 out of 10 children were proficient. We were not telling the truth to parents, to policymakers, or worst of all, to kids. And the reality that they faced were less than 3 in 10 children were actually proficient on the nation's report card. It was an embarrassing and public moment for our state in 2007 when the National Chamber of Commerce gave us an F in truth and advertising and an F in post-secondary readiness. It was embarrassing. And so we made a very specific decision to raise expectations, both for students and for the adults who serve them throughout the system. And so how is that work proven? We've had a tremendous amount of work since 2007. We've had special sessions of the legislature. We've raised expectations again, both for students and for children. And the results of that, we're getting early indicators that that is proving to be good and important work. I would definitely agree with Tom. So much of this is in the implementation and the diligence to get the job done well and properly. But for Tennessee, this last year, we're the fastest improving state in the nation. Of course, I want to be very careful to make sure I recognize Washington, D.C. with their outstanding gains. But it's a significant moment for us in Tennessee and also nationally. We saw the greatest gains in the country since the history of the assessment began. But we are not resting easy. We know that we have tremendous work to do in the state of Tennessee. Our goal is not to be the best of the bottom half. Tennessee remains below the national average, and we know we have tremendous work to do. And so we are leaning into this work, not resting easy. So what does it look like for Common Core State Standards in Tennessee? We're now 4 years into the implementation process. It's been fully implemented, and the work has been pretty fascinating in our state. We are not immune to the national conversation, however. And in January of 2013, when the Tennessee General Assembly came into session, there were 14 pieces of legislation that would impact the standards or the implementation of the standards in some way. Through that process, we've also trained over 42,000, and by the end of this summer, 50,000 educators across the state, 96% of leaders in the implementation process, and that learning and training process is still ongoing in Tennessee. One bill was essentially passed out by the end of session that preserves Tennessee's Common Core State Standards as the math and English language arts standards for our state. There was one, you can call it a speed bump, you can call it a brake pumping, whatever you want to call it. The one decision that came out of that process was related to the assessment, which as for those of us, for the presenters and those of you who cover this work, we know how important an aligned assessment is, because how you measure is ultimately how you define what matters in any sort of assessment. And so we know it's very important, but ultimately the Tennessee General Assembly said, this is very important work. We have a long way to go, and we've got, we think, the right foundational components in place, but we want to be very disciplined about spending an appropriate amount of time on an RFP to ensure we get this right for kids and for educators across our state. And so there are three things I think that contributed most effectively to the work in Tennessee and are how we're continuing to keep this work moving forward. One is a student focus, 2 is collaboration, and 3 is communication. So I'm going to start with student focus, which is the most important part of this work. It is very important for these conversations, because there are so many important adult partners involved in it, to have it focus on adults. In Tennessee, we have had the focus sit squarely with students, and whether that's with the implementation of the Tennessee Diploma Project standards, Tennessee's new Common Core state standards, the evaluation system, accountability structures, a robust and disruptive systemic change period for our state. We've worked diligently to ensure that students are at the center of that conversation, even when the conversation gets tough for adults. So second would be collaborations, very similar to Terry's story in Kentucky. Whether it was within government or external to government, this was an all-in. 2007 was a date that we had a truth moment as a state. And so whether it was the philanthropic community, the business community, educator groups across the board from K-12 to post-secondary came together with policymakers and said, we've got to do something more. So with the Expect More, Achieve More Coalition, which is a group that raises awareness about the standards in our states, talks about why it's important to implement them with a fidelity. There are about 400 organizations representing hundreds of thousands of Tennesseans. Educator advocacy groups and education advocacy groups have come together on this to say this is an important implementation process and we need to keep moving forward. And candidly, I think that collaboration for us is really a key to sustainable change when you have so many important pieces of the process. Last but certainly not least is communication. This was important at multiple levels. It's very important to be transparent with the public. There's so much noise across the country that's been alluded to already, and so much false information. And so it was very important for us in Tennessee to make sure that accurate information is shared in a way where the public, policymakers, and the media can dig into this and make sure that folks are getting the right information. So whether it was policymakers coming into Tennessee classrooms, educators really engaged in a phenomenal way. I'm making sure that whether you were members of the media or policymakers or parents, that they were exposed to this right where it matters in Tennessee classrooms. And so for us, communication, collaboration, and making sure that students stay at the focus of all of this work has been, I think, an important part of our early success, and we're dedicated to making sure that last fall wasn't a moment to celebrate, but it's a sustainable trajectory that will put us with the best of the best.